गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स। डे बाय डे कोविड केसेस आर इंक्रीजिंग इन द एंटायर कंट्रीज। सम रिपोर्ट्स आर सेइंग इट इज़ एयरबॉर्न एंड मेनी पीपल आर डाइंग। सो रिसेंटली द कुंभ मेला व्हिच इज़ एक्टिंग एज अ सुपर स्प्रेडर एंड द इलेक्शन रैली एंड वी आर नॉट adhering to any rules as per the news which are spreading in the internet. So now let us speak about a latest news which has arrived in Indian Express. Explain how the second COVID surge is different. Two metrics illustrate current COVID-19 trends in India. The case fatality rate is lower than during last year's peak, but this is no relief when the absolute number is so large and the positivity rate is higher than ever. On Friday, close to 1350 coronavirus related deaths were reported from across the country, the highest ever. A day later, that number jumped to more than 1500. The only silver lining in the ongoing second wave, that it was causing fewer deaths compared to last year, is now fast disappearing, with the rapidly rising infection numbers are leading to more and more deaths. As a percentage of the caseload, the deaths are still lower than last year. But that is hardly a consolation for a population that is heading towards 2,000 deaths a day, a few days' time. There are predictions that India's daily death count could rise to as high as 3,000 a day, which the US used to record during its worst phase. But with no indications yet of any slowdown in the infection rate, the increase in death count is also anyone's guess. In fact, the disease seems to be spreading at a faster rate than at any previous time. The positivity rate, which is an indication of disease prevalence in the population, is also at an all-time high and rising. No longer the silver lining. The significant lower mortality rate was the biggest comfort during the second wave, which began in the middle of February. Every now when the daily death count is at records high, the death rate is much lower than the last year. During the previous peak in September, when more than 90,000 cases were being detected every day, India was reporting over 1,200 deaths, despite the daily count of cases having crossed 2 lakh. The death numbers were lower than this until 2 days. Maharashtra, which has the highest counts, offers a good example. The state has been reporting more than 60,000 cases a day, but the death count over 400 now is still less than during the peak of last year, when it was reporting even 25,000 cases on any day. The state's fatality rate this week is less than half the overall rate. The weekly case fatality is calculated by comparing the total number of deaths reported in the past 1 week with the number of cases detected in the week that ended 14 days previously. The 14-day period accounts for the fact that deaths usually happen 2 to 3 weeks after the infection is detected. The weekly CFR presents a current picture of the mortality situation. The overall CFR, on the other hand, is obtained by comparing the total number of recorded deaths with the total number of confirmed cases, and it stood 14 days ago. This offers a more holistic view, and eventually the deadlines of the epidemic, once it comes to an end, would be judged by its overall CFR. As of now, Maharashtra has a weekly CFR of 0.89%, while its overall CFR is 2.09%. This kind of situation does not prevent in all states. For example, Delhi, Chhattisgarh, Uttar Pradesh or Gujarat, all of which are in the midst of a big surge, have weekly CFRs that are more than twice their overall CFRs, indicating that the current phase of the epidemic in these states is much more deadly. For the first time since July, India's weekly CFR has overtaken the overall CFR, with more than 1.77 lakh deaths and over 1.4 crore infections. India's overall CFR stands at 1.42%. This is lower and therefore better than in many other countries. In the last 1 week, more than 7,800 deaths have been recorded, while in the week that ended 14 days ago, about 5.13 lakh cases were detected. That gives a weekly CFR of 1.53%. In the initial weeks, the second wave, a low daily death count was attributed to the circulation of a supposedly milder variant of the virus. However, a more plausible explanation is the fact that over the last 1 year, there has been a significant improvement in clinical management and critical care infrastructure. However, last couple of weeks have seen the infrastructure crumble under the weight of cases. Several deaths have happened because of lack of hospital beds or access to critical care facilities. So now let's speak about faster spread. Over 26.6 crore diagnostic tests have been conducted in India so far. Of these, 1.47 crore tests, or even about 5.5%, have been positive in the last 1 week. However, this has increased to over 13.5%. The 7-day moving average of positivity rate has never been higher. The current high positivity rate reinforces the possibility that the virus has spread at a much faster rate during the last couple of months and infected many more people compared to last year. During the first wave, the positivity rate had peaked last July and steadily declined even when the positive cases continued to rise in August and September. At that time, the higher number of cases were a direct result of increased tests. Until most of July, India was carrying out less than 5 lakh tests a day. It was only towards the end of the month that testing numbers began to rise rapidly and climbed to more than 10 lakh a day by the third week of August. Right now, India has been detecting almost 2.5 times as many cases it was during the September peak. But it is not because of any increase in testing. Testing numbers are roughly at the same level as in September and October last year, but many more people are returning positive. Maharashtra has had a very high positivity rate, over 15%. For most of the epidemic, but several other states, including Chhattisgarh and Uttar Pradesh, that had relatively lower positivity rate last year, lower than the national average, are now closing the gap. In fact, weekly positivity rate of Chhattisgarh is currently higher than even Maharashtra's. The high rate could be because of increased contact between people or due to the circulation of faster transmitting variant. There is evidence that both these things have played a role. A new variant which has emerged locally and was first noticed in the Vidarbha region of Maharashtra has two crucial mutations that make it transmit faster and possibly also evade the immune response. More than 60% of the virus sample from Maharashtra collected for gene sequencing show this double mutant strain. The mutant has most likely spread to other states as well. Thank you.